Hi, I'm Oscar van Deventer, and this is Dust Twist 3D. Dust Twist 3D has a tetrahedral structure, and it was suggested by an anonymous YouTube fan of mine. He saw the Dust Twist puzzle, which is this sliding puzzle. And he said to me, well, Oscar, can't you make a 3D version that is, instead of a triangle, a tetrahedron? And of course, I couldn't resist the challenge, so here it is. So what we're seeing is Dust Twist. Let's look at one of the sides. What it does is, like with the original Dust Twist, it rotates. And I'll just take off a piece. So like the original Dust Twist, we have an honor system where you can just slide the pieces off. But okay, when the puzzle is solved, then we have one green face, one red face, a yellow face, and a blue face. And the way that the puzzle is operated is you make rotations and the magnets keep everything clicked in place. And other than rotations, you can make slides like this one. And then we make perhaps another rotation, we make another slide. We slide this one, rotate it, then we slide it back into place. And let's see how we get this back into shape. We make this rotation and we slide it back. And okay, now we have the puzzle scrambled. So it's easy to scramble the puzzle. I have no clue how difficult it is. But before looking into that, how did all these magnets get in there? Well, George Miller told me a little trick. By using tools. We have the north tool and the south tool, or the red tool and the green tool, and they are magnets and they stay together. So when applying the magnets into the edge piece, I used the green tool and I just put the long magnets in with the green tool, making sure that all the magnets have the correct orientation. And of course, for the corner pieces or the end pieces, I use the red tool to push those in. It's interesting what happened, because when you push all the magnets in, they repel each other. So they didn't stay. Actually, when I pushed one in, then sometimes the other launched all the way across the room. So I had to apply glue, and I used toothpicks to keep the magnets in place. And of course, now that they are glued together, everything works well. And what you see in this mechanism is also two types of magnets. So we have the big magnets that really take care of the click, that everything stays in place. And then we have the little magnets that take care of the orientation. So when I make the rotation, it locks at the rotation. So getting back at this puzzle, I'm not feeling really happy about this puzzle, because I don't like these rotations. Somehow it feels like, we don't have these funny rotations for the 2D version, so for this one we shouldn't have them either. But it's really hard to confine these rotations, so it's now a feature. We just have the circular rotation thingy. And also for the sliding, if we wouldn't have a rotation and it would just be a linear slide, then the piece would be misaligned. So we would need the 60 degree rotation anyway, and then there is no canonical way to go from here to there without rotation. So I have the suspicion that the puzzle may be a bit too easy to solve, and my question to you is there any way that we can make this puzzle better, more fun, more what we expect for a puzzle? Or do you think that it's just fine like this? Thank you for watching.